Hello everyone, I'm Krishna and Singh, your design mentors. So today, I see from last 1 week, you guys are throwing me so many questions and every day I have to answer. And though that is really fun and kind of, I can understand your situation of mind, what is going on. But today we are coming with one very important videos and kind of one very important interaction with Mr. Prashant, which is going to help you a lot. I am working with Prashant very closely from last almost a decade. He is a design counselor and mentor. He worked with many industry. He is having experience of many of the brands where he have worked, which we are going to discuss now in the detail in the video. He is the motivational speaker and even keynote speaker from so many events. He has taken a jury for many of the design colleges like the NIFT. He was a part of Meraki, Career Fest. So many events which is very impactful in the design industry these days. So I have seen his importance and how he has worked in the college and as well as in industry. So today we'll discuss one by one and as well as he will guide and mentor you where and what you can do it. You will get to know about the UI UX design, product, graphics, interior, where is the career, what is the opportunities, and even how the brand work and its function, actually how its function is. When I've joined the college, he was the one who was leading so many events and the college days. So here introducing you, Mr. Prashant, we would like to introduce you. We would like his point towards the design as a career and what was his experience during the college days, and he would like to share with us.
Right. Yeah, it's almost been like a decade that I've been a part of this fraternity. And yeah, it's a marvelous journey that if you want me to recall those days, like how I got into NIFT, how I got into my college. So if I talk about design during my times, like 10 years back or 11 years back, not every student were that much aware about what design is, what this industry is, or how probably you can get into such kind of colleges. It was like most of the students sitting in some science room, experimenting on something and still thinking if they're not sure about their career, that what they're heading towards. But then somehow, some or the other way, through some sources, we got to know that, okay, fine, there is something called as design industry where you can get through these colleges. And that was, during my times, it was NIFT that I got to know. So it was during my school days, probably, nowadays in schools, there are a lot of schools where you are being introduced to humanities as a subject. But then that time it wasn't, that easy, or it wasn't that a cakewalk. And yeah, so after post that, when we got into the college, I was in accessory design, part of accessory design. And then, again, we were not sure that in the college, within that design as a subject, within that department as accessory design, what should be my specialization? But then worry not, it's like, slowly and gradually the college mentors you. It's like, it's not about to worry about the career at that very point of time. What we should focus is on the subjects that we are being taught, and then slowly and gradually we crack those things. Yeah, in the college, like Krishna, you were talking about, yeah, of course, we have been a part of the college along with me. I still remember when you came to the college, and I think I was in third year that time in the college, were in first year of college.
Day one, we met outside the MP area, I think.
MP, exactly, yeah. So yeah, most of the colleges, design colleges, it always has something, that unique thing called as, that we call as the MP, and then a lot of fun around the college, along with, alongside whatever that we have when we... as a subjects that we have.
Yeah.
So best part of NIFT experience that I have along with you is that we used to lead a lot of events, a lot of activities together.
Yeah.
But then that time I never realized that something that is going to help me even in the industry when I'm working today. Those are small its and beats of leadership qualities, you might say, some extent.
It's given a lot of sensibility also towards
That sensibility is that responsibility stuck under our belt, and that maturity that builds on top of it.
It's give even a bounding. I remember still when we have done a lot of, I think, sweatshirts for the college.
Right.
And
right.
That's have a lot of problem to us because it's like, transaction of lakhs and lakhs rupees there. And like,
I guess that was the first time that we ever got, to understand how industry works. Like, for example, 90% of our industry people, they are from NIFT. Like, I'm talking about the apparel industry.
Correct.
And it was for the first time when we as students, we got into, getting into some kind of apparel manufacturing. And we had no clue. Like, every college is the college fest whenever we had that. it was the time when we needed somewhere around, you know, I assume it was nothing less than some like in thousands it used to be.
More than that, the transaction of around 2 lakh rupees.
Two lakh rupees.
It just mattered a lot. Like,
yeah, in, during those days, yeah. In the college days, right? Yeah. And we had no clue that where should we get, you know, get it manufactured from, like hunting across industries, all the manufacturing units. And then we realized, okay, it's not that easy. It's not only about the design, it's also about the execution.
And there it comes time. Products, and we went and we done that. I think that printing works also.
Exactly. That's what I mean to say. So there we get to know, there we realize that, you know, how execution is important, or whatever that we were taught in the college, and the kind of industry exposure that our mentors, our college mentors, they used to give us, taking us around the industries. So how these things are important. So
it's really important, but I want to go back again, because you are the one who are from Mathura Road, DPS, Delhi. So it's really very known. You had a good exposure. Still, I got called from so many cities and where the students don't have any information about design and they want to do, they struggle a lot. So what do you suggest, a student from there? How was your journey? What kind of exposure you had? And what do you think about the students are having a problems and what kind of solution they should find?
So, if I talk about the school days back then, like I said, not everybody is introduced to these kind of exposures and this kind of, subjects or these kind of career options that today we have. And the only reason today we have is probably everybody has that information on their palm, that on one tap you get to know what is happening in what place, in what college, what are the career options, or, you know, what are the departments to offer what kind of subjects. Yeah. But that time it was very few. Thankfully, I was in a school where we had science stream, commerce stream, humanities as the third stream. And me being, like I said, normally in those days, what people used to assume or what people used to gauge for their children was either, if you are from science background, you either have to be an engineer or doctor or So same here. I was the student in my school in the science stream. And I was also, you know, being coached by Brilliant Tutorials. It's a coaching institute that is dealing with,
for engineering.
Like those days, it used to be a huge name. And I used to prepare in that. I was a part of that, preparing for engineering. And then I also took a drop, a ear drop. It really matters a lot. And then lately, I got to know that because of my few of the friends from the humanities stream, I got to know that, a lot of people can get into design colleges like NIFT or NID, or there are some private colleges like Pahal. So that's how you get into these colleges.
That's true. Still, we have this thing in the mind. It's not only for a student. I would like to even recommend this to parents also. Design, that means if you are arts or commerce student, right, then only you should choose the design as a career. So here, for your information, even if you will see a students like, you know, a commerce or arts student, they can even join the IIT too. IIT having a course called UC now, last 5 years before they introduced, it was not in our time. So you can get into IIT if you have arts. You can take the admission in IIT when you are from commerce. So we have to think in very different way design. Being a design student, and when I was in textile lab, I was able to explore a lot colors and patterns. Yours was pretty different. You are into product and graphics oriented. But I see design and in fact science, it's having a very deep relation, because enough exploration you can do if you are from science background. You have understanding of subject, product and everything. Well, I would like you to even introduce your course, because product and lifestyle accessories, I always feel when I go to schools, colleges and when I meet parents, so it's very underestimated. People think a very small thing about it. Accessories design of NIFT is just accessories. So what do you think about accessories design, and how you want to introduce this particular course to students?
Right, Krishna, I understand that thing. See, it's very common that people assume or people underestimate accessory design as a department. It's like fashion and lifestyle accessory, or product design and lifestyle accessory, whatsoever you call. Like different colleges have the same department with different names.
Yeah.
But I have never thought of that, you know, it's a small department or it's a very small segment in the entire design industry. Rather, it has a broad aspect. There are a lot of things to do in that department. Like from day one, if I talk about the first year of my college, which is the foundation program, that almost all the departments have to, you know, do the same thing.
Yeah, we all have to do the same activity.
So there is something called as material science, where you are supposed to go and work in the material science lab.
Yeah.
And there you are taught right from a wire bending to how to,
Yeah, we have a subject called I think MS.
MS, that's what. Material
which all
science.
Everybody have to do.
Exactly. Yeah. So, right, you know, like wire bending, you know, putting up, what do you say, nail on the, you know, on a plank board, or then how different kind of, you know, those industrial machines work, like milling machine, grinding machine, router machine, every single thing.
Every single thing we have to draw, write the name, detailing, for that also we have a 5 marks. So it's really, very interesting.
And I used to wonder, why am I doing that? Because tomorrow in the industry, I have to actually design things with, through the help of some CAD, like computer-aided, you know, design softwares that we have. But then slowly and gradually, I realized that it's very important, like in my second year of college, third year of college, fourth year of college. So what all subjects that we had was mainly focused around product design, and not to just one kind of product. Like we have lighting, we have something called as home decor, we have dining and decor, then we have jewelry, then not just product as in a physical product. We have to come up with some softwares or apps in those days itself. Like even then, when, you know, apps wasn't that handy, like mobile wasn't that handy thing for everyone. So when we had those subjects, it basically means that, you know, as an accessory design person, you can do anything. And again, if you see accessory design as a subject, it's like you have multiple aspects. Why again, every time I'm saying this as a multiple aspect, because you are taught to understand the human, you know, ergonomics as a thing, like how you understand a product, whether it's a physical product or if it is something that you have to understand through the user experience.
Correct.
So when you get into all these things, I think you have a lot of options to crack. And that's something which I have realized working in the industry. Like, for example, there is another incident. I started my career during my job through Brick Bounce. You know, my first job was in Brick Bounce Street, where it's an apparel brand, and I was working there as a visual merchandiser. But much before that, during my internship when I was in Wildcraft, and my internship was under the visual merchandising head there, the, you know, retail ID head that we say in the industry. So when I was working under him, he asked me, what can you do? And I was clueless, because whatever that we are taught in college is something that can take us in any direction. It's up to us that, you know, where can we take that? You know, what is that career option that I would like to crack through the help, through help of those things that we have learned? So it was again visual merchandising.
So it's about 8 weeks internship you're talking about.
Right. The summer internship, which is normally for 2 months.
So this summer internship you guys will have in third year of your college. So that means
Third year of the college.
After your sixth semester, 8 week of internship, normally you have to do with the industry. And this is kind of a first, you know, the 8 week works directly.
Exposure
you will have. So it's actually going to impact a lot. And from here, actually, you start your career.
Right, exactly.
Before that, what Prashant has been saying, that, you know, first year is the fundamental or basic you learn from all departments. Right. Second and third year is introduction of, like, you know, your department from basic to software and all. So here the industry introduction is basically we are getting it. So it's like, you know, first year of your college.
Say that you're fresher in the industry. Yeah. Fresher is a word even in the industry.
Yeah. So they will treat you like, you know, like the fresher kind of.
Yeah.
So then, and then the GP, if I'm not wrong, you have done with Arvind, which have a very great industry
graduation project. That we
So that was with Arvind, and that's must be is. The good impact is there, and I don't know. Today I have to know, like, you know, what exactly you have done in Arvind.
So in Arvind, I was working again in the visual merchandising team, because my field of interest
was US Polo team or Edhardi.
US Polo. So that time US Polo, Flying Machine, Edhardi, and L. These four brands used to work together. They had the same operational unit.
Yeah.
So I was a part of the visual merchandising team, where I had to, you know, come up with a lot of visual designs for the store in terms of window designs, in terms of doing the planogramming. I'll explain all this. So, and then again, we have something called as roadshow. It's a huge thing in our industry, like in fashion industry.
Yeah,
every brand
very
has some
interesting,
kind of,
very, very interesting.
Some
even,
kind of trade show. Yeah. Somebody calls it as a trade show. Somebody calls it as a roadshow or something like
that. I would even like to say, coincidentally, even I have done my internship with Arvind only, and even the US Polo team was next to me, and that time True Blue, that's a Sachin brand. So they were working with the same team, it was the US Polo, AHD, Flying Machine, and True Blue.
Right.
So even I had a lot of fun in, like, you know, during this road show, GP time and road show, when you have a responsibility, but you are not responsible here. So it's actually a great fun. meaning is like, you know, you have a responsibility, means you have to do certain work, but responsibility is there, like, you know, your design mentor having that responsibility, they have to answer it to their seniors. So it's great fun when you are as a GP or as a fresher when you are working in industry. So it's amazing experience.
So again, like, coming back to Wildcraft and Arvind, like, both of them were some other kind of internship programs that we had from the college. And that time, again, the important of the department is that whatever that we have been taught, so subjects called as product design, again, we had like HME, like human ergonomics, or the understanding of user experience. So there we had a part of retail design in that, where we were supposed to go to the market, understand the market, see how the stores look, what all impacts that it builds upon you as a customer. And from the customer per se, you look around everything. And again, coming back, taking the design understanding of ours and looking at that in a way that can it be better? And that was that when, you know, when we were doing our internship in the industry in Arvind, or for that matter, Wildcraft. So same thing was there from the industry mentor side. First 2 days, what he asked was, market ghum karao. Like, jao market ghum karo. Literally, that's what he said. And we were clueless that what does he mean by like market jao? And what are we supposed to do? But like, all bunch of students, all friends together, we went around. And that time, like, you know, going around the malls used to be a hype, like mall ghumne jana. I'm talking about those days. Yeah, like, today it's very easy and it's a very common thing.
You
used to go to the malls, look at every stores. Lot of people came back just clicking pictures without understanding things. But again, that's the same departmental importance that we were knowing that, okay, these are the things that you are supposed to study. So we had that.
What
study.
I see here, it's more like a physical. It's not like a spoon feeding those days. The difference between that era and now is, now everybody needs very quickly solution, right, and everything they want ready to, like, you know, okay, sir, it's not like, you know, you want something where you explore a lot, but design. What I believe, even Prashant, like, you know, if we want to learn, we have to explore from the scratch.
Right.
We have given the example of that, like, you know, a couple of a Spectrum event and the Doha, like, you know. So small things which we have, a situation, I can say that, or maybe the design problem which we face, and we handle that, that helps a lot.
Definitely. Yeah.
So
Spectrum is not a small thing, Krishna. See, it's a college fest, and college fest, it's a huge thing, in fact. Like, it's a 3 days event in every college, probably 3 days or seven days events that we have.
Yeah.
And if you are, you know, like, if you are responsible for even a part of it, and we coming from the design background, and luckily our teachers used to, our faculties used to give those responsibilities only when we have some of the other attributes of that, you know, we can.
And from a Spectrum to Converse.
Spectrum to Converse.
Oh my God, this is the best Converse. I still believe till now the best Converse in Bangalore.
Right.
So peaceful, nicely, because Converse is known for. By the way, I would like Prashant to talk about the Converse, because he was like, you know, what exactly the Converse is. The Spectrum, you know, it's a college fest. So what is the Converse like, you know, first year?
Still, when I meet my, you know, colleagues in the industry, if I say friends from my college, who are from similar college, like, you know, from different centers of NIFT, whenever we meet today, there is some or the other day, definitely there would be some discussion with respect to Converse. Like, I have met you somewhere before, even though he's not from my center, from my, like, NIFT Bangalore, somebody's from NIFT Gandhinagar, from NIFT Delhi, Bombay, blah, blah, blah. And it's like, yeah, maybe in the Converse days, we must have met somewhere. So it's an inter-college competition that we have, inter-college NIFT meet that we have. Every year, it's an annual program that happens. And selected students from all the colleges go to the, so, like, you know, whatever the host center is, wherever the host center is. And we all participate in lots of events. And it's another kind of fest, again, you can say.
And I'm not wrong, we have hosted this on 2013.
2013, yeah. So that was my final year batch that we were there, and we hosted that. And again, those responsibilities. So it's the entire design and decor of the college. So somebody is responsible for, you know, changing the whole campus look.
Yeah.
And like, you know, by the virtue of being a part of, you know, environment club. So that time, whoever the faculty in charge, where I'm not able to recall, but then he or she asked probably me to take the entire responsibility. But it was fun. It was like, you know, whatever that we have learned is something that, you know, we have to do the same thing in the college through some or the other, you know.
And best part is, you will have a very good friendship with your teachers and mentor. You believe, like, you know, those days, like, you know, it's not like your regular college days. So the teacher become very good friend. They will work with you, because I was working with head librarian, sir, and I was for the media management, and it was great fun for me. Oh my God, I was getting everything, food, while if I'm driving my, you know, bike, right, so all petrol and all. So there's a lot of things I got those days, and it was fun for me. Converse, like, I got so many great contact. And obviously working day night, I think I didn't sleep. And I think most of us didn't sleep for 2-3 nights.
It doesn't happen. We don't have time for that. It's like everybody is focused on to finish their job. And they're equally excited because the fun element that is around the college, like you said about the food part, those 20 rupees coupon used to be of that importance for us that day. Yeah. I mean, in those days, it used to be like 20 rupees coupon. And again, like, you know, since if we are the senior guys in the college, like, for example, third year or fourth year, and then those freshers, that again, coming back to the word freshers. So those first year people and the second year guys, and like, भैया कूपन नहीं मिला सर कूपन नहीं मिला एंड देन ठीक है हमारा रख लो एंड दैट यूज टू बी लाइक अ ग्रेट थिंग चलो मेरा जूनियर को मैंने अपना कूपन दे दिया वो सब फीलिंग होती है एंड ये सब कहीं ना कहीं लाइक आप मीडिया मैनेजमेंट की बात करें तो दैट मीडिया मैनेजमेंट अगेन यू नेवर वुड हैव थॉट ऑफ दैट हाउ मच इज दैट गोइंग टू हेल्प यू इन द इंडस्ट्री टुडे
ट्रू
लाइक यू नो अप्रोचिंग टू डिफरेंट कंपनीज asking for the sponsorship and making them realize what's the importance of they sponsoring our fest and if they come to our college. So that's something, it's probably from that very time the college has taught us.
No, I learned a lot how to even write the letter, how to approach the Times and, you know, Hindustan and so many papers and magazines, as well as the many, here there are so many channels, I was not aware about it. Where is the office? Although, so after all, it's a great learning after all. It's not only the fun, there is a great learning behind of it.
Definitely.
Well, so moving towards the converse to your first job, you know, it's like, you know, suddenly from college life and converse and all from there, the job, because yeah, I got so many questions from the students, like, you know, what is the career opportunity? So how you see your first job after, I'm talking about here after the internship and GP, because that's the two I already work with a company like Arvind, like, you know, brand like US Polo, which is around 1,000 crore brand, having a very good name, and across the India you will see the US Polo store. So now about the first job and the, you know, the simultaneously.
So it's like, you know, I got my first job that was in Breakbones Street, where just after my completing my graduation project with Arvind Brands, and so it was through the college placement. So when we have the college placements in the final year of our college, so I cracked that, I got into Breakbones Street with, and I also got an opportunity to work with two other companies that was through my, you know, recommendations from my industry mentors with whom I did my graduation project. But then I chose to work with Breakbones because that time it was new in the industry, it was a startup brand in streetwear apparels, and they hired me for visual merchandising. Like I said, you know, whatever department that you get into, but you always have that opportunity to choose what you want to do in the industry. And probably when you make a decision of going into some kind of internship programs or a graduation project.
Yeah.
So that is something that starts driving your career. So probably that's the point where you have to be tricky and calculative and think that what you want to do further in the industry.
Yes.
I mean, I'm not saying that tomorrow you cannot change your career. It's not that. But yeah, definitely that starts paving your path. So for me, it was same visual merchandising again. And when I got into, when I started working in the office, I realized that visual merchandising is not just what we have done in the graduation project or in the internship or what we have been taught in the college. It was much more than that.
Well, so how you want to explain in few sentences, because our students must be, they want to know about all, like, you know what, I know you have worked for UI UX, visual merchandising, digital marketing and the retail industry, as well as the industrial design too.
Right.
All these are different segments these days.
Exactly.
When you have worked for AD, and from there you have learned and you have done all this in all brand. But if specific you ask me, so today even couple of colleges, they have a particular course called UI UX. They have a course called product design, graphics design. But you have almost touched all this, and now you are in lifestyle, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, so that's what I know. So yeah, so this journey from last, you know, decade, you have worked with so many brands and company along with the college. So how you see, so can you please explain one by one, okay, visual design, where and what was your contribution, UI UX, what was that, and like, you know, one by one we can discuss. I think it's better.
Okay, so yeah, let's briefly go through all the experiences I have. So first thing, like again, Brick Bounce was visual merchandising, but it was not just limited to visual merchandising.
Okay.
So visual merchandising, if I'll explain you, it's more of how you want to put the merchandise on the floor in a way that you somehow drive sales. You get the footfall in the store. That's visual merchandising.
Yes.
But then we also had called something called as the in-store design or retail design that we say.
So that means, sorry for interrupting you here, but that is facade also come under of that?
Facade, I mean, these are few of the things that definitely comes as a part of retail design.
So Prashant is getting so much technical. I'll make it more simple here. So when we talk about visual design or facade and, you know, merchandise display. So you see many a store, even in your city, they have a display, they have offer, they have Diwali decoration. Recently, they must have Christmas and now it was the Holi. So all this display which you see in the stores, that is call the visual design,
visual merchandising.
So that is all about he's talking here. So yeah, let's continue.
So along with visual merchandising, we also had store design. So it's not just visual merchandising, but the entire look and feel of the store. I'm talking about the even the furniture design or the fixture that we say in the industry.
Yeah.
So the fittings and the fixture that we have in the store. The color of the store. When I say look and feel, I mean I'm talking about the entire thing. Mm. It's the whole layout, it's the plot, it's the elevation, like, you know, it's actually interior design for the retail store, if I say in the simplest words of mine. So that's what it is.
Yeah, small, even the small pipe gaze also matter a lot.
Every single thing, like what is the light lights that you have, what kind of light you have, what are the flux values of light you have, the AC that you have in the store.
Yeah.
Every single thing, the trial room placement, where you are supposed to have your POS, point of sale, as in the cash
counter.
That
means the even the planogram here, the what we
planogram
have.
Planogram which we say, you know, driving sales through the help of placement of the merchandise. So that's what, how you place the merchandise and in what place in the store, at what, you know, shelf.
So here what I see, the correlation, the first year of the college where you learn the every department work and when you start the industry there you have to work, so there also you need the similar things, like, you know, again the all brands, some understanding of the subject.
It's a cycle. It's like it happens with everyone. Like today if I switch to somewhere else, again I need to have that understanding of how that particular merchandise can be handled, if it's from a, if it's a different category or if it's a different industry altogether. Again, I need to understand that thing.
So like suppose I want to become a product designer or industrial designer, so that doesn't mean like, you know, I should learn towards the product. I have to learn the industry all about it.
Exactly.
Well, so that is the one myth, and I see always kids just keep telling like, you know, I want to become like, you know, a fashion designer. So that will come out like the another videos where we'll talk about what is the journey of a fashion designer. It's not like, you know, just in a back end, if you have like, you know, imagination of the clothes, garment or their design on paper to outfit, that's not only. So same way, even as a accessories designer or product and lifestyle accessory, I would like to say that. So this process should take you in that way. So you have to learn all this UI, UX, retail, products, merchandise. Well, so what about UI, UX? Well,
it was in my second job. So my second job was with Kobo. It's
an accessory. My God, those days, I remember. If I call, like, you know, I see in a Prashant, then I would like to hear, like, you know, Kobo means like, you know, he is sometime in Bangalore, then Delhi, next day Bombay, somewhere like, you know, all airport, I think you have.
See, Kobo used to operate mainly from all the odd spaces. It didn't have a lot of EBOs as such. When I say EBO, as in exclusive brand outlets available in the malls. Rather, it has its placement in all the airports. Like we had in Delhi, both the terminals. We had in Bombay, both the terminals. We had in Bangalore. Then we had in Hyderabad airport. So
and
majorly all the
and you are managing all this.
So that time I used to head visual merchandising and projects both.
Okay.
In Kobo. So I was responsible for the entire store design, kiosk design, all the modern trades that we had, all the distribution channels that we had. So, I mean, you can explain it later, like, you know, what modern trade and distribution.
True. It becomes too much for our viewers.
So it's mainly the entire interiors, the entire look and feel of the store from the scratch, like, you know, taking a piece of land and coming up with the store opening and handing over to the operation team. So that's something which was my responsibility then. I mean, me and supported definitely by my team. So that time I used to be the team lead then, and then they used to help me along with it. So that's how it was, where, you know, post that, I was also supposed to take that on social media announcing that we have opened the store And that time we didn't, since Kobo was also a startup, then we didn't have a lot of social media exposures as a brand. And then we realized that we need to have that place on Instagram, on Facebook. And then we also came up with our own, online platform to sell our products. We had our own e-site. So there it was the role of UI UX.
Okay.
Like how you have to have the mobile website or the app, how you have to have the website through where you, the platform through where your e-commerce site, basically I'm talking about where so that entire design of the e-commerce site, the entire design of the mobile app, how we are.
So you are working directly with the developer team.
Exactly. Directly with the developer team. Slowly and gradually marketing was, digital marketing was also, under my portfolio at that time for some months, I remember.
Okay.
And then again in Instagram, the shoots that we used to do. So again, it was the fashion styling part. So directly dealing with the photographer and, you know,
so doing styling,
the,
also
the styling shoots and everything. So it was like, it was a holistic view of how industry works that I have probably, you can say, you know, I had experience at that point of time.
Well, so what I see here, if we're working like a, this Kobo was a one, I think, premium level brand somewhere here. It's not
brand.
Like, you know.
It's a premium.
So when you talk about this kind of premium brand and on this kind of position, when you have a holistic approach
and
like your heading. So heading sound like, you know, very cool, but actually I've seen a very different Prashant.
It comes with responsibility. Yeah.
So I see very different Prashant those days. He was working and he was traveling like in a midnight and morning. And like, you know, always every
I have second. Days like, you know, I have days when I actually went from Bangalore to Delhi and then Delhi to Bombay.
The same day.
And then and Bombay, like it used to be continuous.
Yeah.
So when I say airport, it actually involves a lot of operations also, when you have to deal with all the departments that work, you know, like work along with the airport team. So it's like BCAS, Bureau of Civil Aviation and Security. So a lot of departments are there. So you have to, and of course, since it's airport, security is a major concern. So you just cannot just walk in into the airport.
Yeah, airport security when it comes, I remember once at Bombay airport, I was like, you know, I was always late. Like, you know, this year also, I already missed one of my flights. So every day, this keep happening with me. One day in a check-in, like, you know, I was there and I was wearing a t-shirt which having a metal inside, and on that I was wearing a jacket.
So
nothing was in my pocket. They were cross-checking it again and again, and they were like, from where this sound is coming? Like, you know. So both of us is confused. Me also, that person also. And suddenly I realized, okay, I have not removed my jacket, because normally you should remove the jacket. So must be there is some incident which you'd like to say, which is a bit funny. Maybe I have that experience. Yeah. You may have a better, because you have spent a lot
of time.
Most of
our merchandise, it has some of the other metal trims. So even if we are taking the back gate, so normally merchandise entry has a, like, it has a different process altogether.
Okay.
But what happens is that just in case if the store manager says that, okay, this particular style of merchandise is, I mean, there are very limited pieces available and they need to be, it has, the inventory needs to be again sent to the store. So what we used to do is, if somebody is traveling and somehow, so we used to ask them to carry it. Yeah. And then just deliver it in the store. I mean, these are something that does happen in the industry at times. So I remember something happened similar where, because of that metal trim, somebody was caught, and then not caught as in like a lot of questions were asked that why this and why so many multiple pieces and why wasn't it taken ahead. So it was a question on the company itself. So these are a few things that does happen at times, but it's okay. You manage things. But it's funny, and at the same time it's scary also, that if something goes wrong, a lot of questions will be
obviously your responsibility you're having. Well, so UI UX, digital marketing, visual, retail, industrial design, and there are so many things which already Prashant has discussed here. If you guys have any question related to this, you can ask here. You can come into our channel and platform. There also you can ask, because Prashant very closely is working with Ignite India from last many years. Together we have participated in many of the Pahal event, as well as we have, I think, many of Meraki, then the social awareness event, then the many of the government schools, as we love. So he is with us with so many event and workshops. So any question if you have, so he's not going anywhere very far from us. So continuously we are here. Obviously we cannot share the all technical things in videos, but everyone having a very different understanding. If you are just appearing for BDS, or somebody is appearing for master in NID, somebody is appearing for IIT in industrial design. So everyone have a different setup question, different things, which I'm already facing. I think, like, you know, you guys are keep asking me the questions related to subject. So obviously those questions you will answer. And we are hoping you can even inbox it. You can even leave the your question in, like, you know, just in our, like, you know, below our video. You can follow on the link and there you can leave the questions. So wherever, some number is also given there also if you have some question, even if you want to interact our mentors. Definitely. So that also you can leave the message. Based on your request, we'll register. We will see your questions and valid question. We'll pass it to the mentor. He will answer you. We'll call you and in a particular time, we'll get back to you. Or maybe we will think on some live session. Like,
that's,
you know,
what I've always been saying. Like, yeah, it's always reverse mentoring for us.
Yes,
also,
so. Yes, yes. So your questions obviously is more important because obviously he brought up in Delhi, I brought up in Patna, but I see there we face a lot of problems. We have a problems are, like, you know, those days, and now even you have so many questions are. I'm getting a questions from Punjab somewhere in, like, you know, some cities in very small tier 2 cities, and somewhere from Patna or Ranchi, or maybe from Kerala and that many of, like, you know, Tamil Nadu. So we are here to take your all questions, to give you overview of about your careers. So parents or students whomsoever having any questions related anything, you can ask. So, and the why this video is to take it forward. So that's what. So any message you want to give, like, you know, I would like to wind up because now it's something like, you know, we'll have we used to watch this video. So let's anything which you want to say.
Krishna. So see, Krishna, I understand that, you know, we have been a part of design fraternity. It's almost been a decade, like we said.
Yeah.
And even those days we had problems. These days also we have problems. It's like the problem doesn't change, just the question changes.
Oh.
No, nothing like wise words from me.
Yeah.
But it's true. Like, I have been into counseling, design counseling since.
Correct,
it's
correct.
Been almost 6 or 7 years.
Yeah.
So when I get such questions, I realize that, yeah, the problems are similar, but has been phrased in a different way. And by the virtue of experience that we have together also, we have cracked a lot of those problems. And I'm sure when the student, if they have that inclination towards getting into a creative industry, somehow they will definitely crack. So there won't be much. And anyways, you are there, your team is there. And of course, like, in case if there is something, I'm always there to, you know, answer the questions.
So that's how Prashant promises right now. Okay, he'll be there. So it's now, you know,
you know what? I really want to end with something better. It's like, you know, I read this in one of the book called as Elusive Creative Confidence, where they said that you ask a question when you are creative and you answer a question when you are intelligent.
Wow.
So that's something that I still believe in, that elusive creative confidence, and let the questions be thrown on us, let them dodge us, and then of course we'll get back.
Thank you so much.
Thanks. Thank you,
thank you, so you everyone. So keep watching.